Good morning, everyone. It's still in the morning time. My name's Lin Sha Jiang, and I had to. I'm the person in charge of uploading all the files. I misloaded my file, so I had to give the revised. That's why. All right, let's get going. Thanks again. Is it working now? How do I do? Up and down. Yeah, I'm doing the. Okay, so I was moving up. Okay, this. I guess this is not a right deal. I'm gonna move fast. Okay, all right. Like many of the artists here, I've also had some interesting experience, if I could call that. I came to this country as a philosophy PhD candidate, not as an artist, but art is something I was always interested in. But unfortunately, in China, many of them just too good. I had no opportunity to get into the art program. So, but anyways, the piece I'm showing, those are early studies from life as student. You can tell that was in 1990 or 1990. And each person actually looking back has a story to tell. By this lady actually eventually found out she's a drummer in the band. I could never imagine she would be a percussionist, you know, in the rock band. And the other person, actually, before this person, was a Eurasian with a father, American father and Filipino mother. And the first drawing, actually, then look back, and he actually was a very proud gay person. So every person, every image you see has a story to tell. Let me just go. They're actually, that's bad. I think I misloaded this one. Let me just go. There are several images in this one. This is an early sequence called Parade of Wind. And I received my MFA at University of Utah. Utah has a lot of open land. And sometimes I encounter something quite different. And by the way, I want to apologize for the slides. Those are the images from scanned from the original slides, and they're not that great. But anyway, there are five of them. Each of the image actually depict a certain stage of emotion or certain stage of experience. You can tell then this will be the number four, and by the time number five, and basically the whole curtain or drapery in the back becomes somebody who is the front covering the face. It's the first time the person is facing the audience, but as you still cannot see the face. All right, there are other sequence called A Ripe House. In this sequence, my purpose was to examine the known and the unknown, and there are moments like this. Often people see this is somewhat inspired by Andrew Wyeth. You know, I saw the image, but when I was doing this, I had no reference to that image. But I did see the house wrapped in the desert when I first saw that one. And I found out later, the beginning I thought was very interesting art performance. It's a wrapped house, you know, like a practice of crystal. But it is for a purpose, practical purpose. They are pesticiding the inside of the wooden structure. And then again, this is another image, actually. The image of the model for all the images, a neighbor's daughter or girl. I had to get permission to observed her, many of her behaviors. I enjoyed many of the things she does as a child. And then I also got permission to pose her and did some drawing from her parents. And this is the last piece. Again, it's a wrapped house. But eventually I changed the image. In the back, instead of the house, I had this door, just a door isolated out of a context. There are others, unrelated single images that also search and celebrate awakening moments of certain aspects of human experiences, such as repetition and reflection. You know, if you live in Utah, you know, in the Great Salt Lake, there is a Sparrow Jetty by Smithson. And And then this actually, it's an image, you know, the one for one quarter target or quarter target. That's before I know there was a Target store, but I like the image. And actually the image, the young man, young boy, actually was my son running. And then I got to know this lady who was actually a grad student at School of Architecture, University of Utah. We often, we were in the same building. We often shared the same elevator. Finally, we got to know each other, spoke with her, asked her, she volunteered to share why she's in wheelchair, because she had a car accident when she was 18 years old. And that totally changed her life. But the way how she handled her life is amazing. She got her degree and also hired by a very well-known firm as architect. And this piece is called Above the Horizon. And also as Chinese person, I've seen many things that could be painted with a special meaning. I got this pig head actually from Montreal, Canada. And crossing the border crossing, they ask what you bring back. I tell them Chinese food. So they didn't examine anything. It is Chinese food. I try after I painted this finished painting, I had to cook it to save the skull. I wanted to use the skull, but eventually they were eaten by ants in the garage. It was not good. Okay. There are another series of paintings that I did actually has more to do with the indirect American experience. I was spending a summer with close friends, house watching, and also they have two kids, and you know, often she shared her family albums, and I found out there are many things I could do. This is titled "Sealed with Wax." It's another moment of life, you know, young boy with adult women, could be the mother or family member. And this one's called Leap of Fish. Another moment, and then Blind Leads Blind. And then this is, you know, another image. This sister and brothers. You know, sister and brother could be involved in many different interactions. And it's a very interesting relationship. You know, I appropriated many images I think best illustrate the unusual situations. And then this is called Baseball. And then this is Measured with Yardstick, father and son. And slow motion. Actually, I started without too much image. Just I kept added, and then added, and then this the final. This one again. It's an image. It personally, I like. Pretty much represents my kind of way of looking the world, and which also is reflected in this child. A simplified rainbow, or rainbow simplified. Okay, there are other mundane events, and conscious behavior are exempt. And those are actually some paintings I did during my sabbatical leave in 2008. And it's much less complex, and in a way it's kind of honest observation. Oh, this is also a painting with my students in the studio. Basically, I set up the pose. Many students are doing the same thing. This is the last few images. It is really American ukiyo-e. Ukiyo-e is a Japanese printmaking style, actually reflecting the commoner's life. Ukiyo-e is simply floating world, paintings of floating world, yeah, common world. America is still a great country, and either as outsider or as a person who is living in the society, I see something quite unique. And and this is to me a little more like myself. And then this is the last one in the show. So that's pretty much represents what I've been doing. All right, thank you.
Thank you.